Right, you join us here for day two of winch fitting. Gosh, it's exciting. Right, a couple of comments came in overnight. Right, first one. Someone noticed, I did notice my radiator was somewhat clogged and dirty, but I hadn't really thought why. And then I was thinking maybe George had done a rubbish job with the pressure washer, but no, my son had not done a rubbish job with the pressure washer. It's the flaps. So people are going, you need to open your flap, Simon. And they're not wrong, because obviously this sits in front, something like that. Well, that the right way around or the wrong way around? That's the right way around. Yeah, that sits in there. And these flaps are there to stop the air coming in. So on a cold morning, your cars are all wrapped up. I was explaining it to Tyler this morning, all wrapped up in a little blanket with no draft going through it. And it's only then it can get to its desired temperature, then the flaps open and push, the air goes through. Now, people are saying you need, can you like put your hand in and like twig it? But if I, all the flaps are joined together and the motor only actually activates the top one. But if you have a listen, if I do it close to the microphone, you can move those and you can hear the motor and sort of, but you can't do it from the flaps. The flaps are just going to twist if you look at that time. So you actually have to do it on that rod there, but you're never going to get in and do that. That's never going to happen. So I have written to Mr. Skywalker this morning and I've said, Mr. Skywalker, sir, could you get something maybe on that InControl app? But that's all gone wrong today, but that's another story. I've lost all my vehicles on it. If I go online, all my cars are there. If I go on my phone, it says, you haven't got any cars, Simon. Don't know what's happening there. Anyway, right. So, Mr. Skywalker, sir, can you work out a way on that remote app? Look, on cue. Do you reckon it's Mr. Skywalker? Should we have a look? No. It's Australia. Who's calling me in Australia? Goodness only knows. Right then, I'll take this. Sorry. Sorry about that. How unprofessional getting a phone call in the middle of a video. But interestingly, that was the guy who runs the Instagram channel, New Defender Mods. I will put the link in the description, New Defender Mods Instagram. He's got loads of cool stuff. So that was nice to have a chat with him. Right, so Luke, can your engineers make a bit on the app, the remote app, the InControl app, and go cleaning mode? And you get into cleaning mode and it goes on, all the little things go open, and then George can do a proper job. Don't know, I doubt they'll do it, but it's an idea. Right, so that was the comments from yesterday. Right, we are now gonna do, right, so let's continue on, shall we, Tyler? So today we are gonna try and get the rest of this plastic off. We've got to do some cutting about, and then we're gonna try and get all the stuff on the floor there all bolted on. That's what we're gonna try and do. Right, so this bit, it says remove it with the six clips, but the clips aren't really that clippy. Hang on, that clippy, I'll show you. You literally just pull this. And what they've got, I've coloured them in. Like, I'm colouring everything in at the moment. It's like a little colouring with Simon. Look, see, I coloured the L663. Did you notice that? There you go, I thought I'd like that. Right, so I'm already mad, Tyler. Right, so these little clips there, just locate that in. Right, so if we go and flash up the laptop, oh, it's powered down while I've been talking. There we go. Right, let's power up the laptop. And basically, we have got to cut some bits. Now, I guess there's something on the winch that it needs to clear. And I think we've got to cut basically this middle bit out.
Yeah.
And a little notch out the top. And then on the middle bit, it's got to come around the corner. It would have been nice. It would have been nice if they'd have injection molded this and put a little mark on it. Now, in fact, Land Rover could change that now, because when you've got an injection mold, you can, if you take metal out of the mold, you can add plastic in. So they could just gouge a little line in the tool there, and then you would get a little raised bit of plastic here. So they could actually, if they wanted to, they could modify these tools relatively inexpensively. They could just get them modified to show you where the cutout are. There's an idea, right. Let's go, Tyler, we're waffling. Right, so this is the picture of what you get full square onto that. So we've got to cut out this bit here and this little bit at the top. So we're gonna put some masking tape on. We'll put the link again below to these instructions in the description. So you can go directly to this page and we will show you this. Right, we will show you this and we'll cut it out. So right, let's get it marked out, Tyler. Right, so this top, you've got to take a little chunk out the top. They tell you to do it 270, which is obviously 135 each side of the center. And the center line runs down between these two sixes. Oh, good job I colored those in, look tighter. So you measure 135 and cut. Now we've had a bit of a disaster, I'll fess up. We've actually cut this out when we videoed it all, and the memory card's corrupted, so I've lost that video. So I'm pretending there's actually nothing under here. So I'm pretending I've had to do it. And then we cut them out in that brilliant video that's lost forever. We tried a couple of things. This is like a bit unconventional. It's an angle grinder with a diamond disc in it. And that worked pretty well. But as you'll see in the next bit, we did actually find the old multi-tool pretty good at slicing through it. The plastic's sort of quite soft. And it's weird. It's soft in some areas. Like this bit here is soft. You can see it's a slightly different sort of matte color. And this bit here is plastic. So that's the top bit you need to cut out. Then you need to just slice this middle section out. Doosh, doosh. Right? Both sides. That's gone. And then you need to do a little chomp, a little bite out here. Now, the top line. So Land Rover tell you it's 85 from here and then 25. So, which is 110. So, but that top line is in line with this crease here. Can you see that, Tyler? Yeah. We recording nicely this time? Yeah. Is it all good? Yeah. And then, so what I would do is go in line with this crease and then come back 25. And they tell you to go round the corner 10 millimeters. So you need to do 10 millimeters down here, which is what Tyler's written you, 10 there. So you do that, that's good. And then you will end up with something that by the powers of magic, there you go, looks like, God, I'm good at this. Anyway, I've saved everyone that horrible noise of me with that vibration cutter. But you'll never know how beautiful I made that look, right. So there we go. So then the next bit we will do, we didn't lose the clip for that bit of the video. The next bit we'll do is we'll cut out these little dog legs that we've got to do on the bottom. So it might be a bit disjointed, but right, next clip now, we'll get on and cut these bits out. Right, so we need to cut these bits out of the bottom here. Bottom, yes, it is the bottom. So we've marked it out. So you've got to come in 180 from this edge, and then you've got to draw a 14 millimeter channel, okay, on an L shape, and it comes down 50 millimeters and along 60 millimeters. So it's not too hard. In from the side, 180, down 50, along 60. So you can see we've got those. Now Tyler's gonna do some work. There you go, Tyler. So I'm gonna try. So we've got this little ingenious setup here. We've got two bits of wood, a battery to counterbalance it. So we should better like do a plunge cut. Right, we will leave Tyler to do that, but I seem to be doing it. Yeah. Yeah, cool. Right, so there it is. We're all cut out, all our little notches, and Tyler's done those bottom bits as you saw. It's quite soft. This bottom bit is quite a soft, rubbery plastic. You could almost cut that with a knife. But we will come back to that later. We will throw that to one side. The next part of the project is we've got to start building up this bumper mount winch bracket frame thing. And what we've done is we're playing the game that we play with every genuine Land Rover instruction, is have they given us the bits that match the instruction? Not quite. Well, it's a no, isn't it? Right, so we have labeled up, Tyler has labeled everything up. A couple of things to note. These nuts are the same diameter, the same thread as these bolts here. But you'll notice up here, why have they put those nuts there with those bolts? They're not the same. That's a bit weird, why would you do it? But then I've worked out, if you look at how they've laid them out, zoom out a little bit, Tyler. You'll know, I think when they're on a piece of paper, the bolts, where they've got these integral washers, must just roll about because they're round. So what they've done is they've sort of held them in place by putting these little blockades of nuts either side. So they've spread the nuts out to stop all the bolts rolling around, which is kind of clever, I like that. That's cool. Right, we went through it all good, 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 good. Right, we came a cropper here. So if you look here, we haven't opened this yet, it's still all sealed. It's got these little screws, and ingeniously, they have left them in the nuts, there you go, to form a little house, and then sort of blister packed, vacuum packed down on top. But if I go to the instruction, right, so what it's showing is these are K1s, are these little sort of funny, it looks like they cut the drawing off there. These here, it looks like we should have 5 of those, but you will see we only have 1, 2, 3, 4. And we've sort of wriggled about and we can't see anymore. And then also these tiny little nuts, which should be these here. We should have 9 of these tiny little nuts, but we only have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, and as Tyler pointed out, it looks like there's a gap. It looks like one made a run for it before the old cellophane came down on top of them all, didn't it? Anyway, it might be under there. We'll have a look. But so there we go. Right. But what do we need for this? Right. First thing Tyler needs, in fact, let me swap over Tyler. Let me have the camera and you can, so you need that. Oh, I'm going to zoom in a bit. There you go. You need that little
N bracket,
and that is going to go onto the front there.
I think it's going to go that way.
And you need a couple of the countersunk. That's right. A couple of the countersunk bolts.
L1 bolts.
L1s, yes, we've labelled them all, like L1.
The extra helpful. 2 Q1s.
Q1s, there you go. Right. And then you've got to get that the right way up, which I think you are. So we have to mount it like so. So it's got a sort of instruction. So, right, allow me, Tyler. And they got these wriggly flanged nuts with a... But they've got a little nylock in them as well, so they're, yeah, and the bolts come from the back. Ah, and in fact, yeah, they've got countersunk holes in the back, so I could just feel there. We might have a look at that in a minute. So they must fit real flush, or I suspect the winch is gonna mount right up to that front panel. Right. Look at that. Check he's not cross-threading it. He's done a little backward spin.
Yeah.
That looks right, yeah. Right, and now we need to rotate it, and then we need to go on, is we need to do the nice shiny bit. This is lush, this bit. Now this bit, it seems to be called a fairlead. Now I'm not into winches, I nearly said that wrong. And it comes with these lovely sort of stainless bit, and then this beautiful bit here. Now it can only go on one way, can't it, Tyler, if you look. It can't go that way because it doesn't sit flat. You've got the corner, so if you spin it round, it sits flat and all the bolts line up. Are they countersunk on that side too? No. Right then, but they're countersunk on the front. Yeah.
The niceness.
And the shiny bolts and the shiny bit. And look, some beautifully laser etched instruction-y things. Yeah, they are super shiny, yeah. Get those on. I'm not taking my car off road now. I don't want to scratch this shiny bit, Tyler. Right, and then the next bit we've got to do is we've got to get this little grill mesh on. So I think you're going to have to rotate the grill again, Tyler. Right, so if you orientate the bumper this way, so we're looking directly into the mouth there with our bracket at the bottom. We haven't tightened that up yet. And then you should be able to position the grill. Now it's got these two little brackets at the side here. Sorry, Tyler. Where's my finger gone there? Make sure they are pointing backwards into it because you can see them on the diagram there. They point backwards. Right, and then what bolts do we need, Tyler?
We need 3H ones. Which are these.
Give me one of those and you can grab a. Don't cut me with that knife. Right then. So there we go. So we need 3 of those that are going to go through. And what nuts is it telling us we need? Are they?
R1.
Yep.
Are the ones that we're missing a few of.
Ah, those little baby ones.
Yeah.
There you go. Because we could do with having to just check that we're not. Now, one thing I meant to add while Tyler's excavating this is when you cut this out, we've followed the instructions, but it might be worth watching the video to check if our interpretation or the instructions are correct and they do line up with whatever. So, again, I'd recommend watching because we haven't really done this yet. Right, you good, Tyler?
3 of those.
And 3 of those. Cool. All right, and then the nuts go from this side and you... The bolts go through from this side. Right, we'll let Tyler get on and do that. Let's just see him get the first one on. And then we'll get everything tightened up. nice and tight, and we'll get on to the next bits. Yep. And there you go, those tabs there, those brackets are pointing backwards as we've got it positioned on the table. Now we are at these brackets here. They're big brackets. I've labelled them L and R. If anyone from Land Rover's watching, maybe you could label them L and R for us, because they nearly look the same, but they're not. So when they go on the car, this little edge, this little ledge here, this folded ledge is going to be at the bottom. And these are going to go, I've got a car right next to me, so these are going to bolt up onto the ends of our chassis legs-ish there. Now, there's a little bracket we need to bolt on that's going to hang down below here. Now, we don't need to do that because we've got that aluminium under tray and we've got this bracket here, and I think we've got the brackets we need here, some of the mounting points, so we don't need to do it, but I'll show you what it is. And also we will put the parts to one side because we're going to look at the end of the kit if we've got bits left over or bits short. So if you needed to, you need to grab these two little brackets. What are they? Tyler, L.
L.
Now, can I wriggle them out? Look at that. Right. Now, again, these are not handed as, well, they are handed, but they're not
labeled
or marked. And if they're cutting this out with a laser, it's no bother to go, but anyway, right. Right. So we're going to have them that way, and it's going to, right. And the bolt is going to go from the bottom through the hole in that one. Now that is going to look okay, isn't it, Tyler? Yeah, that's going to go like that. And then you could put that nut on the top. That one would go like that. That looks right, because then you've got that nut under that slot in line with that. So, but apparently it says we don't need to do it. So it says for vehicles without a front undershield installed. And then we are going to go, as we just said, and we're going to go install these. Now, one thing we need to do is we need to get this little square bit off, because this little square bits, these little square bits even, are left on from when we took it off. So we are going to get down in there, unbolt those. It looks like it's threaded into the aluminium. See, there's no nut on the button. So we should better just rattle those out. What I've done, just to stop them getting mixed up, I've put the L on the L one and the R on the R one. So we're going to take those off, and then we are going to bolt those onto the top of here. So we're going to stand both of these up. That's the orientation they'll be in the car. And we are going to put these brackets on the top. Now, they've given us the bolts to do that. So we'll get the bolts. Which bolts do we need for those, Tyler? We need Q1. And maybe you reuse your, because
yes,
it hasn't labeled those. So we'll get some Q1s. Right, we'll get on. Right, so that's the left-hand bracket on the left-hand bracket, that little square. And then that's the right-hand one on the right-hand one. And that's correct, isn't it? Yeah, because that was the bolt that was holding those, the additional radiator, those low wheel arch mounted radiators, that was holding the shroud for those on. All right, so what are we on with? 13 mil and 10 mil. So I'm reusing the bolts I took out, but they've given us new nuts. All good so far, isn't it, Tyler?
Yeah.
We haven't been anywhere near a loom today, have we?
Not today.
Shh, don't mention the looms, Tyler. There you go. Right, so we have those ready. Now, we are ready to go and mount these onto the car, I think. Right. Now, before we, so we've got that bolted up, before we can bolt these onto the car, we need to also, the crash cans are going to go in also here. Now, be careful with the crash can. The trick to identifying the crash can is one corner is rounded here. Okay, all the other corners are square. Okay, so you'll notice. So what you need to do, the right-hand one has got the corner on the right as you look at it with the right in. The left-hand one has got the round corner on the left. So we need these two parts. So we are then going to bolt through there, and through there. Okay, now, we are going to offer this up. We're going to put the two bolts that we removed from here in there. That will hold that in place. Then we're going to position that, and then we're going to put the bolts in on the inside edge first. We'll see. Right, so let's jump down and have a look on the car, Tyler. So don't worry about the crash can for the minute. Now I've removed these two outer clips here. You need to just pling those out. You'll leave the inner two in, remove the outer two, because there's a plate that goes behind here. Right, so now I've got to get this here, rig all that up behind there. Okay, you can see these two holes now are central. And these are the bolts I took out, beautifully colored. It's nice to be putting some of the bolts back in. These other four holes are not. There we go. Look, we've got enough movement there. Okay. Right. Let me get the crash can. Now, we need the bolts we need, Tyler, were, remind me, they were the, you need two of the big washers, don't we? So you end up with like a double washer because you have to get one of the big washers and one of those bolts. I can't remember which ones they were, Tyler. I'll put the instructions up.
C1
and D1.
Yes.
C1 and D1. So these are going on the inner edge. So, right. I've got to go through there.
Through. Got behind those.
Yeah. Get into those fixings behind. You're a good job, Toilet. You're trying to hold it steady and. Right, so I just line those up. Right, now, these back, now, I get what they're doing here. There's a lot of load gonna go on these. Not so much on this crash can, hopefully these will never see any load at all. Let's hope so. Right, but on this bracket here, there's gonna be lots of pulling as we winch ourselves up off a tree and do all sorts of stuff. And so there's a lot of force pulling on this chassis leg. And they didn't want it, obviously, just concentrated on the 2 points those captive nuts were. So they've got a nice bracket, we'll show you, that goes all the way and sort of reinforces behind. So as you're pulling, it doesn't sort of bend it or pull it away. Right, let's grab and have a look at those, Tyler. So that is, if I'm not mistaken, these two, Tyler. I might have to wake the laptop up. Right, so that is these two. Now, so they're not, they haven't got captive nuts in them. So they're, but the trick with these is they're sort of tapered. If you look at the end, ever so, it's hard to tell, but if you look, you can see they're sort of, so if this bottom face is, this top face isn't parallel, it's running slightly uphill as it comes up this way, whoop, it goes.
I think you can see it.
You can see it, can you? There you go, it's just me, Tom. Right, and you've got to make sure you get these right. So they've given us a little drawing on the computer here about these. And it confused me a bit at first. So basically what they're saying, if that's the car, they could have done a Defender. What's that, a rangy sport? Now it's got the L405, it's got the bonnet vent in it. Right, so what you've got to do is you've got to have this the same. So this is showing you the wedge. And it's showing you that the wedge points, when it's in the front of it, it's pointing outwards towards that corner. So if I come down here, Tyler, but of course it's located behind, isn't it, Tyler? So it's kind of tricky. It's kind of, look, yeah, because you've got this, I see what they've done. So this face here with this little cutout, you see that whoop, that cutout, that has to avoid, there's a couple of ribs, we'll have a look. So it goes on that way, and then we've got to get this, so I'm getting in.
That's the right hand.
So that's the right hand one, yeah. But if I do that, I reckon that's the left hand one. Yes, right. Right. And then, yeah, I don't know if you can get in behind there, Tyler, but can you see where my fingers are there? Can you see the little ribs on there?
Yeah.
Yeah, and so I guess when this goes on this way, that gap is to sort of bridge over some of those ribs there. Right, let's get the nuts and bolts and get those on. Right, so we need these long bolts here, which were, Tyler, remind me?
A1,
D1, and J1.
Yep.
Which has got to be on.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. All right. In fact, let's put both of those in. I am caught. Right, and then we've got to make sure we've got that one that way round, the wide bit pointing out. Right, that should go through that. Right, and yeah, that gets right up close to that. I can feel on the inside there's virtually no gap. It's right up close to that chassis rail. So as you pull, it's not pulling the flange out, it's pulling. Right, we will get those done up, and that's that front corner. And in fact, what we'll do is we'll then do the same on the other side, Tyler. Yeah. So we will, and now, and we will also check. It does give us a point of what to torque these up to in the instructions, doesn't it?
Yeah, later on.
Later on. So we will come back and make sure you get that, because that's going to be the important bit as we go forward. Right, so there we go. So we've got the crash cans on. We've got the main mounting bracket in. We've got it bolted up. Also, when we do the other side, we will put that fixing. There's the little stud in there for the radiator mount for the shroud. We'll get that in. That one there. Right, so we will get that all up to that point, and we will join you again in the slightest of moments.
Someone said to me yesterday, they said, Simon, you've left the washer in the bottom of the box. So I've been rooting around in the box. I think they might have meant that washer there, Tyler. But that actually holds the box to the pallet. So, oh, there's my own last night stressing. Right, we are now ready to fit this sub-assembly. But let's have a look how it goes first. So it fits using these E1, these E1 bolts. Now, Tyler's after a pay rise at the moment, so he said, Simon, why don't we do flash and use copper grease? So I thought, yeah, okay, he's getting good. He's covering my when I forget. So we are gonna copper grease some of these up, like so. Now, I'll show you how they fit, because when it's on, it's gonna be not clear. So you've got four of them, two fire down, two fire up. It goes in this orientation. And there are some captive nuts, come with me, Tyler. There are some captive nuts already installed in our little aluminium crash can. So they are going to go down through there, two down and two down. Right, so do you reckon we can slide it on, Tyler? Maybe you get a greased up bolt as well. You grab one side and then we'll do it and we'll plug one of those in and it's not going to fall off.
Warning, before you lift this bit on, make sure you put your radiator cowl on. We did it in the wrong order, hence mine is on. But do that. Right, now we're ready to get this and lift this on.
Tyler, right, have a ginger grease.
How do you extract ginger grease?
Yes, right, yes. Right then, you're gonna do some work as well as finishing. Okay,
I can do it.
I've got a hand. Two people, look at this. The instructions do actually say it's a two-man job. They didn't account for me, did they, Tyler?
All Land Rover owners are like that.
I know. Right then. There we go.
Right.
I'm going to get that end on first, Tyler, because it's a bit tricky, that end, because I've got that.
Yeah, if I hold this end.
Yeah, go on, you hold that end. Oh, it's heavy, Tyler. Right. Right, where is it? It's sort of fighting me on there a bit. It goes the other side. There you go, it goes the other side.
Oh, but mine's...
But yours is, yeah, mine's too far. Yeah, I got it. Right, and so this is obviously where... I got it. I'm on that side. I reckon.
That's not moving.
I reckon we just need that. See that bottom corner there, Tyler? I reckon I just need to nudge that out a bit there. Oh, there we go. We're good. Right, and then the same up here. That's it. We're good. No, we're on. Right.
Too much.
Right. So we've just had a bit of fun. Now, my advice was. Right, okay, it's quite clever. So what you've actually got here is you've got this bracketry here, that black bracket there, and you've got this front cradle. And what you've got is you've got these two slots, and they're designed so that the bolt goes through the two slots. And when you're with your winch, you're gonna be pulling in tension. So it's there, but it's designed so when you crash, it goes zoop and goes back, and it gives you a crumple and allows those cans to crumple. So what you see here, can you see that? You've got this is the cradle, and then this is the back slot, and the two are held together with this bolt, but they're right at the end, they're both, but it gives them room to go backwards. So it took a bit of trickery lining it up, My advice would be, do not put these bolts in first. Put these top two in here and here first, because we had to sort of rock this to get those in, and they were the hardest to get in. So get those two in, then put your two in at the top and your two in at the bottom. Okay, they were fairly straightforward. We did need to just put a little screwdriver in between the can here and this end flange, just to give them a little bit of room. That might be a tip for someone. Did line up pretty well. I'm just trying to give some tips. It wasn't that bad. Right, and now we're ready now. So we've got the bolts. These are, remind me, Tyler, B1 and J1.
Yep.
Right, these big nuts and bolts, no extra washers needed. So these bolts here went from the inside out. So you got the same deal, but don't do this bottom one first. Do this, there's actually a vertical one here. And that goes from the top down, doesn't it, Tyler?
Yep.
Now make sure you don't get it in the slot. It's, you've got to get it through the little overlap where the two little Venn diagrams mix in the middle. Do you do Venn diagrams? Do you remember those,
yeah,
Tyler? No. It's the little middle bit of the Venn diagram. Right, so that's that one. And then, well, yeah, it's normally the most important bit, Tyler. You're not wrong. Right, and then we can go through again from the, I've got room to, there you go, just wriggle that one through there. But you can see if you didn't get that, this one is gonna stop you getting that one in. So you have to get, so I go top, bottom, and then middle, right? And you can see we've got all these loose now. So I think we're now ready to tighten all those up. We've got those in, we've got this side in. So let's have a look what it says. We'll just check and then we'll see, because everything's still loose at the moment. We haven't done these crash can bolts up. And I can see why now, can't we? Because we needed that little bit of wiggle room just to line everything up. But we're looking good. We've got a shiny bit on the front. Right, let's go. Right, so we're ready to tighten up the bolts. So let me go through this slowly. So again, these are all in the instructions, so you don't really need to worry too much. So these inner ones where you've only got those captive nuts, they're not so tight. They're 55 Newton meters. These outer ones where we've got that big black plate on the back, they're 110 Newton meters. Tyler's just learnt how to use a torque wrench. It's a good invention, isn't it, Tyler?
Yeah.
Well, he says if he could. Okay. Right, go on then. Let's give a demo, Tyler. Go on then. Come on, there. Just show how the torque wrench works for those that may not have. So as you're tightening and the ratchet goes, and then as you tighten up, right, we've got a spanner on the back. We're not crushing any cables. No looms are going to be damaged. That's it, nice and slowly. 110. That is fierce, Tyler. Good job. Good job you're doing this bit. I'd be going red in the face. There you go. So when you hear with the torque wrench, it goes, I think there might be some, they're all fundamentally the same. There we go. Well done. Right, so Tyler's going to get those all torqued up. And then we're going to start from the back and sort of work forwards. Right, so we've tightened all these bolts up to 55 Newton meters. That's these two here and the three bolts on the slidery thing. Right, we've just been looking, we've been rushing around, and I'm gonna have to put the hat of shame on, the cone of shame, aren't I?
Quick fit, fit a cat.
Because what did we do? Gosh, we're offending everyone. We've offended the unions, now we've gone and done quick fit. So when I was putting these down, I labeled these as L and R. Now, I've done it as I looked at the car, out, left, and right, because I've been working on the car, but technically that's not right, is it? So I do apologise, and I will put a note when we upload the video, and I will put left when looking at the front of the car. Okay, have I got, do you reckon I can wiggle out of that one?
Yeah.
I'll try. At least the way we did it was correct. It was just, yeah, I got confused. Which would be much better if Land Rover threw us some rope here and put L and R on some things. If they're marking it anyway, or if they're laser cutting it, just, right.
Well, they just tell you which part number correlates what side.
Yeah, I just put an L and R on, I don't care about part numbers. But maybe people get confused with L and R, like me. Such a hard concept. Right.
Left and right.
So we are doing okay. We have got this. Right. The next step, we have got these little brackets here. Okay. And these brackets are going to sort of go under onto these central bolts here. And they are going to support. Do they line up? Yeah, they seem to. Yeah. They line up. You can see the holes up from the top. Maybe Tyler might be banning it. Oh, you got it underneath. They line up with these two. So we'll get all the bolts together. And we're going to do. Now, at the same time, we also have to refit are one of these. So this is, but there are two different ways. So this is my deluxe one that's got all this big bit here, and this is for my underbody. I think if you're fitting a winch, you really need to have one of these as well, if you haven't already. So we'll get this bolted or sort of offered into place, and then we'll show you quickly. We're running out of time, aren't we, Tyler?
Yeah.
We're getting there, but let's have a go, see what we can get done today. Right, so one little snag. These bolts on this under tray, let me just get this the right way up. It goes in that way up like that on the car. We've had to just extend these bolts upwards a little bit. It seems like these bits are sitting a little lower. So to line up with the holes, we've got to go up. Right, we'll get that on. Right, Tyler's got the brackets. He's done the L&Rs the right way round. I've been demoted. Right, so this bit here goes in the top, and where it goes in between on the red bar, it stops those squashing as we put that together. So let's go and have a look underneath. And what are the bolts that go in the top there, Tyler? That one's gonna go in the bottom. We're gonna need two bolts in the top. Let's get the bottom lined up first. So these are the original bolts we had in, and these are the replacement bolts. So you can see they're just a bit longer to account for that. And that's where you've had to file them there. So this is gonna form an extra support for that to pass through there. Or you reckon it'll just go through the gap there? Ooh. Whoosh. That's some trickery and trickier things. Because that bit there, Tyler, see that little kink there?
Yeah.
That kink has got to go round the bar, hasn't it? That's why they've put that kink in there. But with it in there, I'm going to have to... Okay, you're going to have to get that... Right, you're going to have to put them both in at the same time. Right, so I'm going to have to put that one in. That's it. And then I'm going to have to... Right, can you rotate that? That's it. Right, so there we go. And then we'll have to get that bolt through. Hopefully I can line all that up now. Right, so that's those bottom two. We'll get those tightened up. Right, so these top screws are not too tricky to put in. If you use a screwdriver, you can just line those holes up there and then put these countersunks. This is these countersunk bolts going from the top. So obviously everything near the winch is countersunk to give it a nice flat mounting. So there we go. So that's those in. I've got the spacer bars in, that spacer block in the corner there. So I'll tighten that bolt up there. And then I've got these bolts coming through. So now you can see you've got these support brackets coming down. And as you look at it from the side, what that's actually doing is giving you a sort of triangulation and supporting the front, the weight of the front, transferring it down. So I'll get that all bolted in, and we're nearly there. We're not far off now. So we are done for the day. We have got that all finished up. So that was a day's work for us, day two, but obviously I've got phone calls and other stuff going on. So that's taken us about 5 hours today on and off, but we've also been videoing it and painting it and doing stuff. But everything's just nuts and bolts. Everything, there's nothing there. We had to sort of do a little bit of prying just to get all the bolts to line up, but it was minimal. It was not in any way bad. And I'm gonna say the engineering of this winch is super. The way that it's designed so that if you have a crash, it absorbs the energy and it's all sliding. But if you're pulling, it'll take tons. I think it's all very clever engineering's gone into the front of this. I got a couple of questions I'll ask my man at Land Rover. One is, it doesn't look like, it hasn't told me to put the adjustable air flaps in, and it doesn't look like we're gonna put those in. So that'll save the problem of washing the radiator, because obviously you may need more cooling, because where the winch is going to sit is going to restrict the airflow in this area here. So I think they've done away with that. What worries me slightly is the connector that's left here. I don't want water getting into the loom here. So I'm wondering whether I should cover that, because you can see the contacts in there. So I might need to ziplock a little bag on the end of that. Be nice if they gave you little blanking connectors that you could put on the end of that with seals. So you just plug it on and it automatically seals all of that. So I will be talking to them about that. And I think you're going to need one on the other side because there's the lower flaps and the upper flaps. Right, just a little end note. If you do not have all these instructions online, I will insert some of the pictures. But if you don't have the underbody protection, then you will have to fit one of these spacers. So that's one of the bits I haven't used. Always interested to see what bits we haven't used. So that's those two spacers there you would use at the bottom if you don't have the underbody protection plate, but we do. So let's have a look. What are we gonna do tomorrow? If we get time, we are gonna be on that. So there we go. You can see they show no other flaps there and they've got the winch mounted in. So tomorrow we are gonna get the winch mounted in. I have had a request to weigh the winch, so I will weigh the winch, if I remember, tomorrow before we put that in. But there we go. All quite good. It's taking some time, but we're taking our time. That is it for today. Hope you've enjoyed the video.